In the new GrandMA3 software version 1.7, they introduced a new way of working with your phaser engine, and it's actually quite clever. If you have some GrandMA3 hardware, let me show you that first. Let's build a color chase or a color phaser effect. We select all our mega points right here, and we press and hold the X5 key on your GrandMA3 hardware. I press it down, you can see step comes up down here, and I select magenta. I select blue while I'm holding it, and you can see it already starts. And then I select white. This is how fast it is now to create a phaser effect. You simply press and hold the step key on your GrandMA3 hardware, and then it immediately starts to build a phaser effect. You can see right here, I have three steps recorded right now. Let me just stop it, go into single step. If I go into step number one, it's our magenta color. If I go into step number two, it's our blue color. And if I go into step number three, it's our white color. So if we start it up again, you can see it nicely fades between the three colors. Let's stop it again, go into single step and go into the step number three, which is the white one. We can choose color down here and we can set the width down to maybe 0.5%. And then we can start it up again. You can see now it snaps on step number three. To make this a little bit more obvious, we can go into our A matrix. We can select a wing of two, close this one down again, and go up and spread it out up here between 0 and 360 degrees. And now we created a fun effect. So this is basically the very easy way of creating new phaser effects, or you're working with the phaser engine on GrandMA3. If you don't have any GrandMA3 hardware attached to your on PC, then you have to create a small macro. You can type it out down here, step. You can simply just type step down here, but it's much easier to do it with a macro. So let's just go into this empty slot right here and go into edit. Let's say import, go up and search for step like this, choose step and import the macro. Close this one down and now you have a step macro. So let's try to build the same color effect as we did before, just using this macro down here. We have all our mega points. We say step number one is magenta. Step number two is blue. Step number two is white. This is how easy it is to work with the GrandMA3 phaser engine. If you don't have any GrandMA3 hardware, simply create a step macro and that's going to help you to create your steps. If you accidentally put something into your effect that you don't want there, maybe you put in some position information and you don't want any position information because you're building a color effect, it's very easy to remove that as well. So let's just start with selecting all our mega points again, and we press and hold this step key. We say magenta, blue and red this time. And then we accidentally pushed position number one and position number two, and they start to move in one of the steps, and we don't really want that. So once again, we can go into single step and find out where the problem is. We can see here step number one, they are not moving. Step number two, they are not moving. Step number three, they move to a position and we don't want that. So we go into position here and we simply press the off button, or you type off down here, and you simply press the position here and it removes the information. Then you start the effect again and the pan and tilt information is removed from your phaser effect. You can also introduce other things after you start building your effect. So let's try to build an effect once again. We press and hold the step key after we select position number one. We create step number one, position number two. We created step number two. Now we want to introduce something different. Let's say we need to add a gobo to step number two, for instance. So we go into step number one and we selected all our mega points. We say open gobo in step number one, and we go to step number two and we put in gobo number one. So we start our effect again, and as you can see, it starts again and it changes the gobo in step number two and it takes it out again in step number one. Let's stop this again and then let's talk about this new sheet view they introduced up here. If you press, normally it's in auto mode right here. If you press the sheet up here, it's going to show you the different steps you're in. And as you can see up here, you have a pan, tilt and gobo one value, because this is what's in our steps right now in the phaser effect we just created. So if I look at deselecting my gobo here, I have position number one in step number one, position number two in step number two. But if I turn off the pan and tilt here and I look at the gobo, you can see I have an open gobo coming from down here in step number one, and gobo number one here in step number two. So this is how easy it is to build layers upon layers upon layers in the GrandMA3 Phaser engine. Another really cool feature, and it gives you a lot of much better clarity of what's really happening. Let's try building a flyout. We select all our mega points. We put them in position number one at zero intensity. We press and hold the step key again. We put it in position number two and at full. So right now it starts to oscillate between position number one at zero and position number two at full. So let's just deselect our pan and tilt here in our phaser editor. And now we only affect the dimmer value. We go down here and we set the dimmer curve to snap on and off. And this is basically how easy it is to create a flyout effect. Let's go into our pan, tilt and dimmer right here. And let's put some matrix on it. Let's just put a shuffle on it like this. And then let's go over here and spread it out 0 through 360. And now we created a simple flyout effect, which we can store in our all preset over here. We clear this. They all go back to normal. The one we built before is this one. And then we can clear this and we can put it into our flyout here. This is how easy it is to work with the new GrandMA3 Phaser engine in the new GrandMA3 software version 1.7. Another cool feature GrandMA3 added to their new 1.7 software is a new way of controlling speed. So let's just try something fun. Let's take all our mega points here and let's do a new phaser effect. Here we are, 0 and 100. Let's just put it into snap on and off. You can see it turns on and off the way we set it. So let's go into the speed and see what speed do we have here. We have right now 60 beats per minute. Let's put this up to 100 beats per minute. So now this oscillates 100 times per minute. So let's go into measure here and set this one down to 1. Right now we set the speed to 100 beats per minute. So each cycle now is going to be there 100 times on a minute. And if you set the speed to 100 beats per minute and your song is 100 beats per minute, you can now go into measure in here and say, but I only want this to rotate or to run through the cycle every second beat, then you can set it to 2. Then it slows down, but it's still in sync with your music because the speed still comes from 100 beats per minute. And if you say, okay, this is still too fast, I only want it to occur every 4 steps or every 4 beats, then you set it to 4 here, and then it's still in sync with 100 beats per minute, but it's divided by 4. This is a new functionality they added in the new 1.7 GrandMA3 software, and it's quite clever, and I think you are going to use it a lot in the future. So I hope you liked this video, and I hope you will consider liking the video on YouTube. That's going to help the channel out a lot, spreading out to more people. And you're more than welcome to subscribe to the channel if you want to. And if you want to learn more about GrandMA3, then I suggest you should check out this next video you can see on your screen right now. We try to upload a new video once a week. So I hope you got something out of this one, and I hope I'll see you next time on this channel. So until then, happy GrandMA3 programming.